welcome again to Sanford's Chess Club Chess Championship 2011. Tonight it's Tony Harvey versus Roy Day, and it's Game 4 in Group B. Let's go straight to the match and see it from the start.
I'm playing Roy tonight, on white, so I'll play C4.
Hello, yes, I'm playing Tony Harvey this evening, and he's much higher graded than me, so I'll have my work cut out. I don't know how to approach the game yet. We'll have to see what he plays, but for sure I'm going to have some work to do. Tony played c4. I'm now going to play e5.
E5. I'll play knight to f3.
Tony has played knight to f3. And I considered the better move, really. I could have played me knight to c6, but I decided to play d6.
I'll play d6. I'll play b4.
Right, Tony's played d4. I think it's too dangerous to leave, so I'm considering taking it, so I'm just going to take it off and take a pawn.
Boy's played e takes d. Knight takes d4.
I thought it'd be better just to play knight to f6, get me pieces out.
Knight to f6, knight to c3.
Once again, just to get my pieces out. Bishop e7, yeah.
Bishop to e7. h3.
Yes, I was worried about these knights here, and I just wanted to prevent them coming in onto e5, so I just play a6.
a6. G4.
Yeah, I don't like the look of this. That was a really good move on Tony's part. He's going to come down there now. If he perseveres with that, I'm going to be in trouble. Anyway, I think we've got to play h6.
h6. Bishop to g2.
Yes, Tony's getting his pieces out, so I need to do the same pretty quickly. So I'm going to play the knight from b8 to d7.
Knight b to d7. Knight to f5.
Yeah, Tony's played his knight to f5. He's hitting my g7 pawn here, so I've got to do something about that. I think the best I could do there is to castle, so I'm going to castle.
Well, it's castled. Knight takes on d6.
Tony's just won a pawn. I don't want to take the knight because it will attract his queen down onto me. So I'm going to play queen to c7. I think that might be the best move for me, I don't know.
Queen to c7. Knight to f5.
Tony's put his knight back there, so I need to do something constructive if I can. I think what I'll play is bishop to b4, tying the knight down.
Bishop to b4. Queen to b3.
Yeah, I thought Tony might play that queen to b3. And I think I want that bishop there, and I was thinking of bringing my knight up. So I'm going to play pawn to a5. Tony's Castle, so what I intended doing in the first place was to play knight to c5. I know he's going to take it and it'll be an exchange, but it gives me freedom down the middle here, I think, and it frees my bishop as well. So I think perhaps that might be my best move. So I'm going to play knight to c5.
Knight to c5. Bishop takes knight.
Yes, as I thought, Tony was going to take the knight, so I'll just recapture. Bishop takes bishop.
Bishop takes c5. Knight to g3.
Tony's played his knight back. I thought he would. He's played it back to g3. I would have taken probably. So I'm going to pin his queen with bishop to e6.
Bishop to b6. Knight c to e4.
Well, Tony's brought his knight into the middle, so I'll just take it off. Knight takes knight.
Knight takes on the e4. I play knight takes on the e4.
We've got an exchange of knights, so I'm going to bring my bishop back to d6, where it's guarded by the queen.
Bishop to e5. Rook a to c1. Bishop to e5. Rook A to C1.
Wait, Tony's played rook to C1. And, we're at about time now, so I'm just going to do something quick. That's why I played that. Bishop to H2. Check.
Bishop to H2. Check. King.
Played with king to h1, so I'm going to play my bishop back to e5.
Roy plays bishop to e5. Rook f to b1.
Let's play this rook over to d1. So I've got to do something right here, wrong there. I'm going to just push and I'm going to go for it. I'm going to play pawn to f5.
G takes f5.
Turn this play pawn takes 4. Obviously, I'm going to take the bishop. Bishop takes pawn.
We'll take bishop takes f5. c5. Check.
Right. So let's play pawn to c5. So I think my best move is to put king to h8.
King to h8. Play knight to d6.
Tony's coming with his knight to d6. So I think my best move is to play the bishop back to g6.
Bishop to g6. King to g1.
Okay, the king's gone back to g1, so I'm going to play rook to d8.
Knight to c4. bishop to f7. Queen to a4.
Right, the queen's gone up to a4, so I'm going to, I think it'd be easier for me to take the rook. I'm just going to take the rook on.
Roy plays rook, takes on d1, check. I play rook, takes d1.
Turn as we captured with the rook, and we're both in time trouble. I'm a bit worried about this, so I've got to play fast, and I think it's quicker to take the knight off of my bishop. Bishop takes knight on c4.
Roy plays rook, takes on d1, check. I play rook takes d1.
Right, he's taking the queen's taking the bishop, so I'm going to play rook to d8.
Rook to d8. Rook to b1.
Okay, Tony's gone back to b1 to protect the pawn that I was attacking. I think I'll play rook to d4, attacking the queen.
Rook to d4. Queen to e6.
Well, this looks dangerous. The queen's come up to e6 now. Don't like this. So I'm going to bring the rook back to d8.
Rook to d8. Bishop to e4.
Right, Tony's played e4, bishop to e4. And I'm going to play rook to e8, threatening the queen. Oh no, I've done it now. It's all over, I think. I'm going to resign. He's going to take my rook off now, isn't he? Oh dear, never mind. Thanks for the game, Tony. I'll resign now. Thanks.
Now normally we would have had Rich Garrett here tonight to do the analysis, but Richard couldn't make it, so I'm going to stand in for him. There's two points I want to make here. The first one is earlier in the game, Tony made an absolute horrible mess of a move which could have led to, virtually resignation. He played knight back to g3, but he completely overlooked the fact that Roy had bishop takes knight. And instead of the knight being protected by the pawn on f2, there was no way he could retake because of the pin by the queen against the king. But Roy misses, and of course, Tony didn't miss his opportunity when it came, and that's what it's all about.